Myself, Niyati Chauhan, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology, Department of Instrumentation and Control. Our subject is Industrial Data Communication and Distributed Control System. Chapter 2, DCS Basic Packages and Topic Local Control Unit. So let's start. We know that in DCS configuration, we consider local control unit. First, dedicated card controller, then unit operations controller, local multiplexers, remote station, super communication and sub communication, power supplies, input output, and controller 5. In last lecture, we have discussed about all local control units. In today's session, I discuss controller 5. Controller 5, the solid state electronic portion of the locally mounted equipment is a special purpose mini computer programmed to perform the control function for which the distributed control system is being used. So for controller 5, we use mini computer, right? And which is a locally mounted equipment, and we use in distributed control system. It has an input section and an output section. But the major portion of the circuitry is made up to the central processing unit. Okay, so maximum portion that is made of the central processing unit in controller 5. Communication between components. So how to communicate with all components? When a control system consists of several digital devices, they have to be able to communicate PLC supplier A with a DCS supplier B. So here we have taken one example. Suppose supplier of PLC is A and supplier of DCS is B. So how to communicate both device of a gateway to convert the data from format to another? So we use different field bus, mode bus, right, gateway for data transmission from one device to another device. You can see in diagram, the data highway is the communication device that allow a distributed control system to live up to its name, permitting distribution of the controlling function throughout a large plant area. So here we use data highway, right? And we are using data highway for communication our device, and we use for large plant. Data highway vary in length as function of traffic capability and speed of transmission. So data highway, here we vary length of data highway, right, through its distance and through data transmission. Data highway length can be in excess of 5 miles. You can see in diagram. So here you can see high level operators interface, supervisory computer, PLC, traffic detector, multiplexer, local control unit, dedicated loop. So all devices connected with data highway, and that's why we are using data highway in distributed control system for communication with all devices. The control console equipment in control console equipment, for we have discussed all components for high level operators interface and for low level operators interface. So here in this diagram you can see one graph is shown in diagram. In this graph we take on x axis distance and on y axis we take speed of data transmission. So here we take three cables, first crested cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. So in crested cable, if distance increased, then speed of data transmission is decreased. You can see in graph. Thereafter, for coaxial cable, if distance increased, then speed of data transmission that is also decreased. But comparative to twisted cable, its speed is high. Thereafter, for fiber optic cable, compared to coaxial cable, fiber optic speed is high if we increased distance. The control console equipment, we know that high level operators interface and low level operators interface. In low level operators interface, we include local control units. So in local control units, main part that is communication. Okay, without communication our device will not run in our plant. So data highway design, how to design our data highway? The most popular medium is coaxial cable. Several suppliers supply highway made of twinex cable, a twisted and shielded coaxial cable. Means depend on supplier, right? Which type of PLC we are using, which type of DCS we are using, okay? Thereafter we communicate devices. Data highway design. Shorter highway may be constructed of pair of twisted and shielded copper wires. For small distance, we can use twisted cable or coaxial cable. Fiberglass cables are used most common for point-to-point connection, and fiber optic cable we can use for large distance. Fiber optic is attractive for use as a data highway because it eliminates problem of electromagnetic and radio frequency interface. Ground loop and common mode voltages. So one advantage of fiber optic cable is fiber optic cable reduce electromagnetic and radio frequency interface, right? Some noise and distortion reduced by fiber optic cable. An optical interface, OEI, unit is required as a node on fiber optic highway. This use an LED to change electrical pulses coming from a controller file or from an electrical highway into light pulses. So here we can use LED, right? If you have a seen fiber optic cable, then you have an idea about this, right? In fiber optic cable, we use LED, right? So this use an LED to change electrical pulses coming from controller file or from an electrical data highway into light pulses. the light pulses are changed back into electrical signals by using PIN diode. Okay, so again we change light pulses into an electrical signal, and for converting in electrical signal we use PIN diode. A light sensitive device that produces an electrical output when exposed to light. Okay, so here we are converting in electrical form. Okay, thank you for watching video. If you have any query in this topic, then you can ask me. Thank you.